we're going to talk about using peak flow, which is a nice measure of how one is doing when they have asthma. I will talk in a little bit about what peak flow meters are used for, but I just want to show the correct use of using this peak flow meter. This is what they look like, and what you basically want to do is stand up and breathe into this device as hard as you can, sort of like blowing out a birthday cake across the room. So stand up, take a big breath in, as hard as you can. Be careful that you don't spit into the device. If you go, it doesn't really work. You need to put your mouth all the way around this device, like that. Now, you want to mark where that peak flow is when you feel good. Everybody who has asthma needs to know what their best peak flow is. When you do this the first few times, you may want to measure it a couple times so you get the hang of it. Then, somewhere that needs to be recorded what your best peak flow is. Many peak flow devices have a marker on here, you can see that, which is green. That tells you when you're at your best. And then based on how you're feeling, you can measure your peak flow when you're having a flare to find out if you're really having an attack or how severe that attack is. Now, everybody with asthma, even if it's mild, needs to have a backup plan to tell you what to do when your asthma is flaring. And then based on what your peak flow is, we can give you recommendations about increasing medicines. The other time the peak flow plays a role is if we're trying to determine where a cough is coming from. Frequently, a cough can be from too much mucus dripping down the throat, or it can be from having an asthma attack. Well, if your peak flow is generally very good and you're coughing and your peak flow is the same, it tells us that it's probably not an asthma cough. The other way a peak flow meter can come in is distinguishing between anxiety and panic attacks and asthma. Asthma attacks and panic attacks can mimic each other, and if people begin to struggle for breathing and they measure their peak flow, they can be reassured that they're not in crisis, they don't have to call their doctor, and they need to chill out and relax. It's okay to use albuterol in any situation, but if the albuterol does not work and your peak flow is good, we need some other type of therapy.